calls to boycott Whole Foods now as technology being used by one of the locations is eerily similar to what we will be seeing with the Mark of the Beast. So what is going on? We'll talk about it because that's what we do. Welcome, everybody, to Not By Sight News. Yes, a blind Christian guy here reporting to you on the news of the end times and so much more. Thanks for spending part of your day with me today, reminding you, as always, that we walk by faith, not by sight. And for someone like me, well, that's kind of my only option. Now, it's important to talk about this, and I know, you know, we're probably going to get about 20 views on this video, despite my channel having 12,500 subs, because YT suppresses and censors my content all the time and never sends notifications for videos. Nevertheless, we'll talk about it anyway, because this is a major step, another major step towards the end time Bible prophecy, that being the mark of the beast. What am I talking about? Whole Foods in Washington, D.C. has recently come under fire over this brand new technology, this new shopping experience, because it's being branded as convenient. And of course, people love convenience, and it's that convenience that's, well, going to lead many people to take the eventual mark of the beast. This is just a step in that direction. Now, let me say this about Whole Foods, because I've been talking about this now for years. Several of the stores had already implemented the Pompeii. So I've talked about that before, you know, and this is all part of Amazon One and the Pompeii technology that Whole Foods has been using now at many of its stores. You know, you're a customer, you come in there, you go to the checkout, you swipe your hand, you know, you're good to go. Everything's all paid for and you walk out the door and you're set. So that's already been going on. So that was kind of like, you know, step one. But now here's step two. The store in Washington, D.C. This is a huge store, by the way. And you got to see this. I have a video clip of how this all works, and I'll put it for you in the description below. But yeah, in order to even enter the store, so this is different now, you have to scan a QR code upon entry. Very interesting that you can't even be in the store, even just browsing, unless you do that first. I think you see where this is all going, right? So the shopping experience is going to be like unlike anything you've ever seen before. You go into the grocery store, this is completely different. And make no mistake, this is the future of shopping. Now, this is a four-step process when you're in the Whole Foods. So it's not just scanning upon entry. Oh, no, no. I'm going to go down the steps that are required, and we'll talk about it. This is interesting. Really quick, though, guys, if you could, I need your help now in a major way more than ever before. Would you consider making a generous donation to support me and my ministry? As my channel, as I mentioned before, continues to become increasingly more suppressed and censored by the day. YT is doing everything they can to completely take me out altogether. And they don't allow these videos to get the proper visibility and audience that they deserve. Remember, I have over 12,500 subs, but these videos can barely average 50 views a video. The likes are way down. The interaction is down. It's all by design. Okay. They don't want me here. And you know what? They might get their wish before too long, unfortunately. But look, guys, if you enjoy what I do, I mean, this isn't me begging. People say, oh, you're begging and this. And no. People don't have to donate if they don't want to. But I offer the opportunity because it really helps me out. There's a lot that goes into this, the preparing, the researching, doing these videos, being completely blind. Takes me a lot longer than most other people with full sight would. So here's how you can help. And by the way, any amount you can do, no matter how small, how large, it all adds up. Simply click the Super Thanks button down below on this video here, which is how you can tip me with a one-time donation of any amount. It's very easy to do from the main video page here. Or become a premium member of Not By Sight News, make a monthly contribution, join my Patreon. It's as little as $5 a month. Patreon.com/NotBySightNews. Link in the description. When you join Patreon, you're getting an uncensored and unfiltered experience for my videos. Again, all videos go up there too, like YT, except you can comment on everything without any fear of censorship being anything taken down. Also, you will actually get the notifications for videos. Remember, that's not going to happen with just the YT alerts because they rarely send those out to anybody, which is another reason why the views are so low, because no one knows I'm putting videos out. It doesn't even matter if you hit the bell icon. I don't even advertise people to do that anymore because it doesn't even matter. No one gets these hardly anyway. But with Patreon, you don't have to worry about that. You're going to get alerted for all my stuff, and you could even send me DMs there. So check it out. I really encourage you, give it a try. patreon.com/notbysightnews, link in the description. Big thank you to everybody already contributing and those thinking of doing so. Thank you as well. Your generosity greatly appreciated. So here's how this works. I told you it was a four-step process. The first thing you got to do, scan your QR code before you even are allowed into the store. What that does is it will check you into the store and create this virtual shopping list. So as you're going around to different items in the store, you scan them and it goes onto your virtual list. Then when you get to the checkout, here comes the second part. You have to scan just to enter the checkout. So once you go through the checkout, have all your items, again, you can even do the Pompeii there if you want to check out that way, or just, you know, scan it on the QR code on the app. But then you got to check out again, step three, just to leave the checkout. So, I mean, you got to do it a second time when you're at the checkout. So two times there. And then the final one, the fourth step, you have to scan one more time to leave the store. And people are not happy about this because let me tell you, this will eventually become the mark of the beast. It's not going to be in a phone, though. It's going to be your hand, your right hand, or your forehead. As Revelation chapter 13 discusses, that all would be required to take a mark in their right hand or in their forehead, and that no man would be able to buy or sell without that mark. So, stores like Whole Foods and many others that are using this technology, I believe, are going to be among some of the first to implement fully the mark of the beast when it's here. Remember, the phones are not going to be a thing at that point. They will not. You'll simply just scan your hand up to some sort of a scanner or whatever at the front of a store, your right hand or your forehead, and that'll be your ticket in. Just like now, they won't even let you in the store unless you scan the QR code. That's major. Because what is that saying? You can't buy or sell. No buying. Can't come to the store and make a purchase. So we've seen many types and shadows of the Mark of the Beast. And a lot of that, too, was going on a few years ago, if you remember. Certain individuals were, well, not certain individuals, but any state or any store in general that had a mandate in place that you had to show proof of the little vaxivax, they wouldn't let you into the store. So, again, you know where this is all heading. We are fast approaching the end. But that also means that at the same time, Jesus Christ himself is returning soon for his church. Now, again, I'm going to put a link in the description if you guys want to check out how this Whole Foods thing works. And maybe you're in the DC area and you've experienced this yourself, and I encourage you to chime in if you'd like to speak on it. What I want to do right now, though, is something I do on all these videos, and that's end this video on hope. It's called The Salvation for anybody who has not yet received Christ as their Lord and Savior. I want to lead you in a prayer to do that now. This is a prayer you could do in your own words, but I will give you the steps you need to bring it before the Lord today. First thing that you want to do, right off the top, acknowledge that you are a sinner. That's something we all are. The good news is that God gave his only Son, Jesus Christ, to die on that cross for the sins of all the world, as he died and rose again for you and me. He paid the cost. What you have to do is repent of your sin, which means to turn from your sin, not just to say you're sorry and then jump back to your old ways, but to actually turn from sin, which are those lifestyles, patterns, habits, behaviors, things in your life that go against the word of God. If you humbly go before the Lord, though, and ask him to forgive you, he'll wipe your sin away, and the Bible says he doesn't remember it any longer. And then you invite Jesus into your life to be your Lord and Savior. When you do that, you become born again, a child of God. You will have eternal life. Trust me when I tell you there is no greater decision you will ever make than the one you do to give your life to Christ. And I pray you make that decision today. Again, more info down below. Don't forget the links to donate to the ministry are there as well. Join the Patreon for as little as $5 a month, patreon.com/notbysightnews. Or just hit the super thanks button down below on this video here to tip me with a one-time donation. It's all a great blessing. Thank you all again so much for watching. I really do appreciate it. I'll be back with more. You guys take care. Please be safe out there. God bless each and every single one of you. I'll talk with you soon.